Could this be the end of the European Union? Guy Verhofstadt admits the European Union is not working, and he's making a plea for a meeting concerning the European Union's future. Verhofstadt has pleaded with the EU to urgently hold a conference in order to discuss the future of the EU bloc, and he warns European values are beleaguered on all sides. We know that Brexit, of course, Britain is trying to get out of the European Union, and various other members, such as Italy and France, and even Spain, are not happy about their conditions. Even Hungary, migrant crisis also has caused this to be a very big conflict. Now, the chair of the Brexit steering group tweeted, Russia and Turkey, Hungary and Poland, Moraya and Minsk, European values are beleaguered on all sides, and the European Union is late to act. The conference on the future of Europe is needed more than ever, he says. What does the European Union stand for, and how do we stand together, strong together? Verhofstadt, an advocate of the federalization of the European Union, is referring to unrest and political crisis all across Europe. Yesterday, Greek police fired tear gas at migrants who were protesting in the Moraya refugee camp on the island of Lesbos. The camp was set alight. It was the refugees themselves that caused the fire during riots between migrants and police. At the Belarusian capital, Minsk, dozens of female protesters have been detained after attending demonstrations demonstrate the release of opposition leader Maria Kolesnikova. Now the 38-year-old is in jail in Minsk on a charge of undermining national security. Vladimir Putin has firmly backed Belarusian President Alexander Lukashenko's crackdown on any opposition to his position. We know that Lukashenko is totally corrupt. He doesn't want to leave his post. And they're cracking down on any people trying to take away their thrones. So you can understand the situation. Mr. Verhofstadt also mentioned Hungary, where another positive leader wishes to consolidate as much power as possible. Prime Minister Viktor Orban wants Hungary's parliament to pass an emergency bill this week that would give him sweeping powers to rule by decree without any clear-cut cutoff date to his reign. In Poland, Mr. Verhofstadt mentioned that there have been increasing calls for a Pole exit. In other words, Poland wants to leave the European Union as well as growing far-right sentiment. In Poland, the Pro-Right of Life Foundation has been chanting homophobic slogans and putting up posters linking homosexuality to pedophilia as well. Now, during last month's election campaign, Polish President Andrzej Duda said the promotion of LGBT rights was an ideology more harmful than communism. And then there's the ever-present eye of Vladimir Putin of Russia, who sees Eastern Europe as within Russia's rightful sphere of influence and dominance. And because of Russia's history of being invaded by European powers, Putin and Russian governments in general will always seek to buffer zone in Eastern Europe. Putin still has some political and economic leverage over former Warsaw Pact nations in Eastern Europe, and is particularly controlling through the natural gas that Russia supplies to Europe through pipelines that run through Poland. So there's a lot of problems that European Union has to face. And besides that, the economic loss because of the pandemic and what it has to shell out in various European Union member states. This is by Brian McLeland on Express UK. Please leave your comments. Thank you. If you'd like to join me on my Patreon account, you will hear content not covered by mainstream media. These riveting stories will be based on my research, and I will state my opinions and give my personal insight on diverse and controversial subjects and world events, events not covered by mainstream media, and not supported by YouTube guidelines. So whatever I have on my Patreon, most of those will not be on my YouTube channel. Please consider becoming a member today. More of the most significant and important videos will be on my Patreon channel. Your support helps me to continue my research and keeps this YouTube channel alive. And we depend on your support, your generous charity, because we help economically challenged families here in Athens, Greece, in Kapota, and we also help the young generation with university tuition and the community around our church. Thank you.